What's good, y'all? Welcome back. Today we are going to be reacting to Chasing Davey, another short film by NASCAR Race Hub. I hope you guys are enjoying the little mini series I'm doing for like Davey Allison and learning about this legend. If you guys haven't seen it, check the last two videos out. Pretty sure you guys will enjoy those as well. But as always, original video link will be down in the description. Let's get into the video.
Allison was in very critical condition late Monday night after the helicopter he was piloting crashed at Talladega Motor Speedway.
He was on his way to the track to watch family friends, Neil and David Bonnet, test a Busch Grand National car.
Mr. Allison died this morning at Caraway Methodist Medical Center.
Every history book on stock car racing will include Davey Allison.
Davey Allison is going to win the Daytona 500.
This is the latest in a series of tragedies that the Allison family has experienced in the last 5 years.
He was the son of legendary driver Bobby. He was a husband and a father of two.
This is such a generational sport.
Growing up, I was probably the biggest Davey Allison fan out there. I think, look in any pictures of my childhood, and I'm always Davey Allison shirts with a Davey Allison hat. I did think that he was the coolest character.
Here he comes. Davey Allison wins the Champion Spark Plug 400.
I want to dedicate this race to my dad because he's the one that made this all possible for me.
I've spent a lot of my life trying to figure out what's a healthy way for me to experience my dad.
On the sheet.
Santa ate his cookie.
And it was a little hard because we didn't live near the Allisons or my grandparents. My mom decided it was better that we grew up in Nashville near her side of the family.
It was a terrible nightmare. And so I just went away. And moved to Nashville, closer to family and friends, and start over and did our thing and focused on raising the kids and, did the best I could.
It was really hard for me sometimes to think, you know, what if my dad was here? Would he like what I'm doing? Or, you know, would I be grounded? Having to wonder, you know, would this make my dad proud?
Even though we didn't live around the Allison side of the family, I was always drawn to racing, and so I started driving when I was 8 years old anyways.
He had the good-looking fire suit and the best-looking half-scale cup car you've ever seen.
I was involved in a pretty serious crash, and my mom really had a scare.
Reality hit me right there. And I mean, you can see that on my face, and I look at that, and I mean,
that's an angry mom
that's
right
terror.
There.
That's mom terror.
That's what
right
my mom was like. That's what my sisters were like.
He looked at me,
when
and his lips
voice.
Were quivering, and he had tears in his eyes, and he said, "Would Daddy be proud of me?" That's when it all stopped for me, because I was like, "That's it, you're done."
Oh wow!
I'm sure there's moms out there that would say, "Isn't that overreacting?" Is that well, there was so much pain and fear associated with racing that I just couldn't. I couldn't do it.
That's completely understandable.
My family had been through a lot of tragedy even before my dad. My granddad had gotten in a bad accident in 1988.
We got a spin back on the backstretch.
Bobby Allison involved.
That ended his racing career and caused some memory loss. And not long before my dad passed away, his brother, my Uncle Clifford, he was lost in a crash on the track in 1992.
I was not going to experience another loss. And so I put the driver's suit and the helmet away, said, "You can't have it, sorry." And that was that.
So she pulled me out of it and said that, you know, I could do it again when I was old enough to make the decision myself.
And that was the good move to say, like the good thing to say.
I did rebel
because he should have that option
from
later on in life.
School, and part of that I expressed through, you know, having tattoos. got into fist fights, you know, stuff that have kind of been long-running problems with my family.
There's Bobby Allison's gun, and there's a fight.
Oh, shit. Oh, shit.
I was bartending.
Punch mans.
Definitely didn't stop wanting to be a race car driver. And so I decided, like, you know, it's time to stop putting my dreams on the back burner. I'm going to go do it.
This man moving. God damn, that shit looks scary.
To help coach me.
My father was a pretty prominent car owner in the 80s, and both Bobby Allison, you know, Robbie's grandfather, and Davey Allison, Robbie's dad, both drove for my father. So obviously I go way back with the whole Allison family. We've just started out really slow. We're just trying to teach him the very basics of racing.
Oh, shit.
He has an iconic name, but he doesn't have really the experience to go with the name. So he's 22 years old, and we're basically teaching him the things that a 12 or 14-year-old kid would learn.
I qualified second by 30
seconds.
Minutes.
Dude, nice.
Thanks.
Nice. Who got the pole?
Enzo Fittipaldi.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. You have the genetics, obviously. You have a lineage that says you can do this. But when it comes down to it, Bobby Allison or Davey Allison is not going to drive the car. You're going to drive the car. So that means you have to learn all the stuff. You have to go through all the learning curve. All the stuff that they went through, you've got to go through.
I really enjoy this backstory.
You're going to excel until you go through the bumps and the bruises and the, you know, the heartache of it and the pain of it. And, you know, and then it happens.
Like, this is a real follow-up on, like,
this is a process that takes years. There's going to be days he probably going to question his decision. But, you know, you'll never know what I have to say.
That's why I stopped talking.
Last year, Lauren started me in karts, and I've been moving up, and now I'm racing street stocks.
I think one of the greatest things about Lauren is, you know, he never runs out of stories to tell me about my dad, and, you know, stories from when he was younger and he was trying to make it.
It's real easy as a teenager to go goof off, and, you know, and then he's in a position where he was Bobby Allison's son, that almost gave him a license to goof off, but he did just the opposite. He was engaged. He knew what was going on with the cars, and he knew what it took for his dad to win races.
It is Allison by a car length.
And he had a lot of grit about him. He just had a lot of want to.
Lauren was the one who actually convinced his dad, Harry, to give my dad his first ride at the highest level of NASCAR.
And I said, I honestly believe Davey's the guy. This is the guy that we need to get and make a star out of him. Now, my dad didn't agree with that in the beginning. We had to kind of debate it. And then he bought into it. When he bought into it, he was 100% into it.
You know, he didn't, you know, go out and use his name to get ahead. He worked every inch to be there.
There it is, Davey Allison.
You gotta work for where you want to be.
Being famous and making money. He wanted to win. You can't be the best if everything is handed to you. You have to figure it out on your own. If I can do one thing towards my career every day, I'm doing pretty good.
I want to say this. I feel like NASCAR is such like a close community in the sense of like I was going to say earlier, years down the line, they're following up on his kid and like the development he had growing up, like what it was like. Like, it's like a whole like little mini, like it's a short film. And like, it just like little things like that, just to like give more backstory of like the greats, is just pretty cool, because I feel like people don't take the time to really do that anymore.
All right, that's a good starting point. Start now, start fine-tuning it. Little things, telling little adjustments. It could be better here. Let him start.
One thing I think I can do better, I can't drive it in anymore down there without hitting the wall. But down here, I can drive it in just a little bit deeper,
yeah,
and arc it a little more and come off low and straight.
Straighter, yeah.
I kill people coming off.
Right.
All right, here we go.
If I'd been real with myself, I don't know that I would have been surprised that he would have an interest to do it. I just think it was the fact that it was meant that that was going to happen then. Like, oh boy, here we go.
Oh, that's probably terrifying for her. Oh shit, already?
That's not good. Caution. Hope we didn't hurt it.
I really need to like watch races in a room by myself.
Okay, he's adjusted for it. He's doing a good job. Let me tell you something, you can run here, you can run anywhere.
It's just a level of trust and just letting go. If he wants to reach out and feel that connection with his dad, I mean, goodness knows there's no better place to do it than in a race car.
Yeah.
And it's certainly, he's surrounded by the people that can help him get to know his dad.
It was sort of a surprise, at least to me. Was it a surprise
to you?
Yes,
certainly was, yeah.
You wanted to know if he could stay here for a little bit, you know, and I said, sure.
He's only known his dad through my side, and now to be surrounded by all these other people, like, he's seeing the more rounded, the whole person of Davey Allison, and I couldn't give that to Robbie.
Okay, that was your dad. Can you imagine a tiny little baby?
He's tiny.
Yeah.
He was, to begin with.
Yeah, not for long. Not for long.
Not for long.
The littlest things that just like touch this part of me that I've never felt before. And, you know, I mean, just like the most random, minute little object that just like completely ripped my heart apart. I'm like, that was my dad's first spoon. Like, that's incredible.
I feel like I hear a new story about my dad every day. That's something that I crave.
Well, your dad's season in 92 was great. You know, yeah, one Daytona, won everything, but and when he, none of us ever expected that would be the last chance he had at his championship. I think everybody still thinks about that a lot.
Cooking utensils. Grill.
Chuck and I were just talking about Dad's 92 season.
It was a crazy year, but you know, everybody always focuses on like everything that happened on the racetrack. And to me, it was more about what happened off of the racetrack. You know, and that's the side that most people didn't see, but that's the side that like, you know, changed your dad. Up until the last year of his life, racing was number one. And you know, quite frankly, family was probably number two for a while. And then the kids came along and that and certainly softened him and changed him. But it was that last year, the year that we had in 92. There'd been so much tragedy in their lives and Davey had some terrible accidents that year. And he either crashed or he won. There was nothing in between.
Cannot get over that wreck.
And it really changed him. It was all different after that, and family became priority for him. And you know now, you know I guess I understand why.
I think yeah, maybe there was something being sent to me, you know, through the little wrecks at Daytona in practice, here in the race, Martinsville, Charlotte. You know, something was trying to tell me something along the way. Wake up. Open your ears, open your eyes. You know, I don't know what the future holds, but whatever it is, I'm gonna try my best to do it right.
Man, can't be mad at that.
See you.
Hey, it's very nice to meet you.
Yes, indeed.
In my own racing career, family has been such a huge part of it, and being able to grow closer to my grandparents is so special for me. And being able to see the way that his face lights up when he comes with me to one of my races, it's like I can see the age just melt away from his face.
Yeah, for a long time we didn't get to see much of him. You know, to be able to
be so totally opposite to that. And plus, not only have his consideration, but his friendship. All it takes is another 10 or 15 years and you'll have it down pat.
Awesome. All right. Hopefully we can fast track that a little bit.
Yeah. Yeah, let's hope so.
You know, I don't know how important what I'm doing is to other people, but I can certainly speak to how important it is to me.
This is what that matters. Do, you know, this is what we know.
Do what your heart tells you.
When I was in Talladega recently, went to the graveyard, and I have this odd habit of anytime I visit his grave, I take my shoes off so I can feel the grass on my feet. You know, make a physical connection, if you'd call it that. Sat down next to his grave, and I felt a lot deeper of a connection. I attributed a lot of that to feeling more of a connection to him on a daily basis. And also, I understand much more who he was now than I ever have before.
And I think that he would be proud of what I'm doing today.
Watching things like this is so hard because it just makes you think about your own life and you're just like, fuck. Like, I'm gonna grow up and certain things are gonna happen. I'm just gonna have to be okay with it or deal with it however I deal with it. And it's just like, life comes at you fast. Life comes at you real fucking fast. But I hope you guys enjoyed this little short series. I surely enjoyed it. They did an extreme dive, like a before, a after, and then an after after. It was great. Love the series. I hope you guys enjoyed the reaction. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see y'all in the next video. I love y'all. Peace.
They wanna fall, what? Back when I was down bad, was stuck in the mud. That nigga didn't cleaned up Louis V on the so-so. What?